two of a kind?
Means?
This is the first of its kind?
He'll tell you.
Yeah. This is just being hot off the press, just been inaugurated, the first of
few
its
minutes,
kind.
Few minutes ago.
Yeah.
First of its kind in Goa?
First of its kind in Goa, but a concept which is quite popular all over the world.
All over the world.
Yeah. And hope to make it popular in Goa through the efforts of Donald.
How does it work, Oscar?
The way it works is, Bookworm is supporting this initiative
right.
by providing the books. So the books that you see here are just a sample combination of what Bookworm will provide.
Right.
Then once it is open, people will come in and just borrow their books. Some will return them, some may not.
That's based on honesty, based on the...
Yeah, exactly. But at the same time, a number of people will donate books.
Right.
And that's a big plus.
Right.
And so... people will donate books because we've seen that in Bookworm, through our work in Bookworm. People are quite willing to come back and give books.
I see.
Books will come back. And then the idea is to arrive at a nice equilibrium of books going out and books coming in. And in the process, fine-tune what each locality needs.
This is the first in Goa of its kind. Bookworm had one at Panjim.
Bookworm has a number of
okay.
other... Bookworm has a very large library.
No, no, but they had one of these in Panjim Municipal Garden.
In Municipal yeah. Gardens. So, though the event based, where we yeah. bring the books out on a particular event or during the Chambal sale,
yeah.
we have a permanent thing in Aldona, which
right.
which is out of our. It's housed there, it's a mini library, but it does a lot of work with the people around
right.
Aldona. And people from the community come and read, and the kids come and read.
That's so called the Memorial Library, Alban Kutto Memorial
yeah,
Library.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Right.
So that was set up through Mrs. Kutto
yeah.
in memory of Alban Kutto, and so it's all the Alban.
But this
Kutto.
Is virtually the first of its kind in
this
that
is,
sense.
This is the first of that sort.
People have tried out other things like second-hand bookshops, and but not pick what you want.
Yeah,
give what you want.
So the challenge is the honesty principle has to come into play here. You have faith in it.
I have faith in the fact that there will be a balance. Some people may take
Should
the books and
Should we walk
and
up and because of the noise?
Yeah. So, some people may take the books and walk off and
right.
never to be seen again.
Right.
But I'm sure there are enough people who will want to refill this.
Right.
In fact...
take this.
Yeah. Ha 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 ha. Okay. So the newspapers will be borrowable or read here? Borrowable. You know, in Maharashtra they have a good model where they actually keep some kind of plastic stands for newspapers.
Yes.
These stands, particularly in Ratnagiri, Sindhudurg, in those areas.
Yeah.
And they are fabricated by them because they have a demand for them, I guess. They have a lot of industrial estates also. Interesting. So you are saying that hopefully more people will give back than take.
Yes. And I guess depending on the location, it'll depend. If it's a convenient location,
you'll
have a lot more people coming in. Donald believes that if he, you know, puts the word out, he'll probably get a lot more books.
Right.
Then will fit into this first cupboard before it is expanded, you know,
right.
to other places.
Would another possible challenge be the need to also weed out and keep on cleaning up and uncluttering the place?
In terms of books. Oh yes.
That would be that.
Absolutely.
So it's volunteer driven?
It's volunteer. Yeah, that's
peaceful come. Inside. It's more peaceful inside.
This is your office, Donald?
Small office we have. We believe in fast work and small office.
I see. Interesting. So Donald believes very strongly in volunteerism, no?
Yeah. I mean
it works. No, it's a model. No, I'm fine.
Get the breeze.
It's fine, don't worry.
So basically it's just a concept, things looking like, you know, how we can activate people, children read, maybe children, like my children don't read books because it's all inside, so at least if they can go and take one book and read, and then we intend to use those books in our shelter homes also, so that the people with disabilities
yeah.
they just turn some pages
instead of keeping being yeah, bored and
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, so you know it may
No, it's a great idea.
It may, then we'll also
it's a fantastic idea.
We'll give it to orphanages so that, you know, they can give it to the children, you know, other shelter home. Anybody, see, it's not a patented idea.
Yeah.
Anybody can, you know.
Can replicate it or take it forward or
yeah,
adapt
or they,
it.
Or they can approach Bookworm also for books.
Or replace,
they have,
replicate.
They have a house full of books.
I see.
So you ask them for one box, they give you two.
Yeah.
So, but I feel that, you know, if you put some 20, 30 cupboards like this in different parts of Goa.
Yeah.
Because the COVID is still on, you know, children are not reading, it may not,
right.
we not know, like, you know, future whether people will know what are books, or will they be books, or you know,
whether they'll just lose the habit of reading. That's what they said. Someone said in 200 years we probably
It's already happening.
Will not need
to
read.
It's already happening. The habit of reading is under severe challenge today. And I was just telling him before you came in, today, even with adults, today you find people in very senior positions, late 40s, late 50s, they don't read. They don't read.
Many houses, middle class houses, don't own a book.
So reading is under threat. Fortunately, with kids, it's still considered to be an exciting activity. A library period is considered fun. You know, book reading is considered fun. So, and that's the way we try to keep it, so that, you know, trigger people and help them, you know, get them interested into the art of reading. And of course, studies show that if kids get into it, it helps them in so many other different ways.
Not just academically.
Not just academically,
Because all the time mobile is not good.
It's unhealthy also. Unhealthy, and it's also a consumer's model. You can't, you're not in control of it. You're just absorbing. Books, you have more in control, which book you read, how you read it, how you relate to it. But actually, you know, I just want to say one thing. In Malaysia, I saw this experiment where they collect books for prisoners.
Yes, it's different options.
In the shops, they have these things. Donate a book for a prisoner. So people like, you know, and prisoners really read. And if you tie up with the prison ministry or something like that.
They are already strong with the prison. So the options are plenty where the books can go.
And you need different languages and so on.
Yeah,
so those are the other areas of diversification.
Like I told you, it took us 5 years to reach this place. So it will take another 1 year to reach the book. It is a process. No? Like nothing can happen. But it is a concept where, you know, we can attempt to make people read. I'm just using it for taking the books to the shelter homes. So the shelter home people can read it. Or passerbys can read it, people from the village can read it. You may never know, like, you know,
where it goes.
Yeah, I mean, it's not that the cupboard is not obstructing anybody.
Yeah.
It's not disturbing anybody. It's for a cause. It's for a cause. Keep it here.
Carry on, I just had my tea, it's fine. Okay, if you brought, it's fine.
You brought little tea only.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Come. Take this and go. David. So, it's just a concept. We don't know.
In a word, I know street providence has been well documented, written about much, spoken about very articulatedly by you. But briefly, the idea of street providence, in a nutshell, I'm sorry to be so unfair, but in a nutshell.
So it's basically how we can reach out to the people who are lost. That is includes the street people who are mentally, physically and intellectually disabled, and people who wish to get off, who wish to start a second life, second chance, an opportunity to come back into society, that's all.
So it's much more than just rehabilitating them in a physical place.
Yes.
You are rehabilitating them in more ways.
Yeah, I mean, the projects we run now are run by the people who have got off the streets and have got no place to go. So they are the people, the guy who set up the cupboard today.
I see.
I would not be able to do what he did, but he segregated the books and said, this is fiction, this is whatever some terms. He said, okay, fine, just do it. I mean, he knew what he was doing.
Yeah.
I would just take the books and put it in the cupboard. I mean, I'm not. So it's you know, just bringing out a talent in them, what they can do to feel important to society. So it's I was telling him it's a backward and forward integration. So how we can run the home with now the books are coming to my homes, or the newspaper. It may be a 2 day old newspaper, but it's a newspaper. So
right. It still has value.
Yeah, of course.
It depends how you treat the value.
Correct. So the bank is close by. He gets newspaper Economic Times.
Okay.
I mean, it's a newspaper. Even if I take it home to read Economic Times, at least I'll learn something.
But reading a 2 day old paper is better than reading no paper.
Yeah, absolutely.
So at least have some idea.
Absolutely. Same thing with magazines or whatever. You know.
Magazines, of course, have a longer shelf life.
Shelf life. But even today, though magazines are kind of on their way out again that's under threat. But today, people are quite willing to read a 15-day-old magazine or a 20-day-old magazine, particularly older people who have time on their hands. They're quite willing to read it.
Right. And Donald, just by the way, the best places to know more about street providences are your talks. Given at TEDx and our
website.
No, there's one more project at, that was Dr. Lewis who spoke. TEDx Panjim.
Enough.
Your talks are there. Okay, I like the way you document your work.
Yeah, I mean, see.
That's an important part of the process.
See, the technology is given to
Made
to be
use
used.
Of.
To be used. So when we started these fridges 5 years back, I had an idea that there were grants and stuff like that for food. But now, this May will be 5 years, and now central government is coming up with a very big grant to feed the poor. So it will go to people who have been having the experience too. So, you know, same thing with the cupboards. I mean, I feel that we should do something for children. Even if 1% children read the books in Goa, I mean, it's still 1%, na? True. Those 1% also will not read.
Yeah.
So, you know, if each village has one cupboard like this, you never know.
Brito alumni class of?
91.
You credit them with a little bit for sharing the value, for spreading the values or planting the seed in you?
100%.
Why?
It depends. Education is very important because, you know, it gives you, opens your mind to multiple things.
Who were the men in your life in the school who impressed, shaped?
You see, I was not a good student in the school, so I will not be able, I mean, you know, but... 25 years ago
now. Yeah. I mean, in our time it was Ivan Rocha and those kind of...
They were still there when we were there, but you know, they had grown old.
Yeah, yeah. They were much more dynamic when... Yeah. When.
Albert Louis, Ivan Rocha, Gomes.
Yeah. Madam and...
Madam and I...
The hero in my life is are two. Ivan Rocha and Almira, the librarian.
He was there for long.
And the way he very insidiously came and, you know, convinced you to read a book. He'll whisper in your ears, boys, read Biggles. And you get this feeling that there is something into it and you really found something. Anyway.
Yeah, yeah. So it's good to see a Biggles fan. I read most of those Biggles books, when I was a kid. Yeah.
Those were different times, no?
Yeah. Amazing books.
Your early 70s? School days?
School days, no. School was, I passed out of school at 68.
68. Where?
68. Delhi, Columbus.
I see.
St. Columbus.
St. Columbus.
Yeah. So the Irish Christian Brothers were in school. So we had a library period. And in the library period, it was compulsory that you took one book in and one book out during the period. And while you were in the library period, it was for choosing and for reading publications. So it was
magazines,
which were there on the tables, which you could read. But the book you could take back.
I see. Some schools have had a better reading culture than others.
Now with this mobile, the technology, you know, I'm not sure that reading is priority in any child's. I'm not sure because in my house it's not a priority. Okay, my son reads the newspaper in and out. But
at some stage, I will share my experiences with you, but that's a separate.
No, but we should try to get this concept to attract people to read, even if it's an adult.
It's important.
Yeah, I mean,
it's very important to get people to read.
That is true.
Yep.
Which shapes your future.
Yep.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for
Thank you.
Thank you.
So